Good afternoon, students. So let's get started with today's lecture. I hope you have tried to solve the homework question. If you have solved it, you might have seen that it is solvable using four states, not more than that. Okay. So let's see how we can do it with the help of some trick or with the help of some shortcut. Am I audible? Kindly let me know. Is my screen visible also? Kindly let me know about that.
So that yes, sir.
Okay, thank you so much. So let's start today's lecture. It's basically I will solve yesterday's question, the homework question. First of all, by providing a shortcut, it will be really handy if you keep this in mind. You might have obtained the solution with four states, if I'm not wrong. I will also get the answer in four states only, but with the help of some shortcut, so that you don't need to apply some logic over and over again in such questions. Okay, so today we'll see some different kind of questions where the complexity might be a little difficult, the problems might be a little difficult to understand at first, but the logic is very simple. Okay, so let's if it's visible on the screen, then you might be able to see it that I have applied a logic, I have applied a formula over here. I will write down that formula over here. First of all, read it, whatever I have written. If the nth symbol from the right end is fixed, okay, in such questions, we find out the total number of states first. Also, in the previous case, it was something like the nth symbol from the left end was fixed. In that question also, we found out the number of states first. The same thing we have to apply over here also. In the previous case, if I'm not wrong, the formula was n plus 2, which is total number of states. In this case, the formula is slightly different. We have to go by a formula which is something like this. If nth symbol from the right end is fixed, in such a question, find out the total number of states first. In this case, the total number of states will be 2 raised to n. Similarly, total number of final states will be nothing but 2 raised to n minus 1. Okay, write it down in your notebooks. If we want to find out the nth symbol from the right end, which is fixed basically, in such a question, we have to apply this formula, straight away, straight cut formula, where number of states is 2 raised to n, and the number of final states would be 2 raised to n minus 1. So in your question, what is the value of n? Because I had told you that you have to fix the second symbol from the right to be as a, right? So n is equal to a in your case. So number of states would be 2 raised to 2. N is equal to 2, in fact. So it is nothing but 4. Number of states would be 4. Similarly, total number of final states would be 2 raised to n minus 1. That is 2 raised to 1. That is 2. I guess you have got 2 final states or 1 final state. Let me know that. All of you have got 2 final states or 1 final state? Because if you have done it using our previous logic, then you might end up with 1 final state. If not, yeah, Mihir, Isha, correct. Because if we go with our previous logic, which we have done so far, then you might end up with 1 final state. If you have completed such a question with the previous logic, kindly send me your solutions. Okay, either you can mail me or you can WhatsApp me. Let me go through them. I have this solution with me. I will discuss this. And once you send me your solutions, I will go through them and let you know whether they can be used or not. Or if you feel today's solution as comfortable, you can go with this. Okay. So if things are clear, let me get started with my solution. I'll have to go through your solutions first. Where you have got the answer with 1 final state. If it's correct, then you can continue doing so. Or else you can see how I am solving this particular question with a different kind of a logic, with a different kind of perspective. And then you can choose any of the solutions. Okay, clear? So now what I need to do is, the logic is very simple. Follow me. Follow this particular logic over here. First of all, we always construct the table. We need to solve any problem, we need to construct the implementation table, right? So whether it's an FA or an FSN, I'm assuming it's a finite state machine. So I'm taking S versus I. The inputs are A and B. What are these states? The states are Q0, Q1, Q2, and Q3. How many states are final states? There are two final states, right? So the logic for highlighting the final states is very simple. The bottom most two states would be your final states. So Q3 and Q2 will be your final states. You see over here, number of states are four, number of final states are two. So the bottom most two states would be your final states. Clear till here? Kindly let me know if I'm going fast, I can slow down. That is what I'm saying. This is a shortcut, this is a logic. I will explain it. Finally, when we draw the diagram, you will come to know how it works. Okay. Let me complete this first. This is a very shortcut which I'm depicting basically. You can apply this in your final exams also. So let me complete this first, see the diagram first, and then we will simulate by taking some examples, and then we will check whether this logic holds good or not. If that is what I'm saying, if you're comfortable with your previous logic, you can apply that. If you're comfortable with this, you can apply this also. So let me complete it first. So as per our formula, we are having four states, out of which two states are final states. So the bottommost two states will be your final states. Okay. Now, how you need to fill this table is very simple, very straightforward. See, we are having two inputs, A and B. Okay. Now, if your A symbol is fixed, what you need to do is kindly write it down. Kindly write it down. A is your first input, B is your second input, right? So if A's value is fixed, if A value is fixed, I'm writing it over here, then add odd states, then add odd states in A column. This is the logic. Over here, whichever input I am fixing, in this case I am fixing the eighth input, A input A I am fixing, so I will only add the odd states in the A column. Odd states are nothing but the odd numbered states. Pay attention properly, the complexity of these problems might increase. Okay, whenever I am saying odd states, I am talking about the odd numbered states. For example, Q1 and Q3, these are your odd numbered states. Clear with this? Any doubt so far? See this description once again. If A value is fixed, then add odd states in the A column. Similarly, if we had fixed the B value, we would have added odd states in the B column. Whichever input is fixed, we will add odd states in that particular column. Clear? So what I need to do is, there are only two odd states available, Q1 and Q3. So I will write Q1 over here. Next will be Q3. And we have run out of states, odd states. So what we will do, we will repeat it once again. So once we have written the odd states Q1 and Q3, again we will repeat it Q1 and Q3. Clear? Any doubts so far? So basically, we have added all the odd states in the A column. If we run out of those states, we have to simply repeat them once again. Similarly, what is left over here? We have to fill it up with the even states. So it is Q0, Q2, again repeat it, Q0, Q2. Now see, there is a pattern. Very simple pattern it is. It goes something like this. This start with Q0, then Q1, then Q2, Q3. Again, we have exhausted the states. So start with Q0, then Q1, then Q2, and Q3. This is the pack. Kindly have a look what is happening. Okay, you got the logic behind it? If yes, kindly let me know, kindly acknowledge, so that I can then proceed with the diagram. This is just a simple shortcut. In the exam, no one is going to ask you how you got this particular table. At the end, if your diagram is correct, if your simulation is correct, your answer is correct. So you will get full marks for it. Okay, so this is just a shortcut. I will give one more question based on this, and the things will be much clearer. Okay, so the problem is not solved yet. We need to construct the diagram also based on this. So how to construct the diagram? It's really simple. Diagrams are really simple based on this. Akriti, this fixing logic, we can you have to check. You have to check. I haven't checked it with the previous problems. Kindly check with one of the problems and let me know if it works out. I will also do it. I will also try it. If it works out, I will let you know. Okay. I haven't tried with the previous problems, but in this case, what is happening? The we are fixing the symbols because the question is something like that. You have to fix the second symbol, third symbol from left and right end. So these are different sort of problems. That's why I have explained this logic in this problem itself and not in the previous problems. Okay. So that's why you can try it out. If it works out, can you let us all know? That is what I'm saying. Now, the criteria for using this logic is nothing but you are fixing a particular input. In the previous cases, we were not fixing the second symbol or the third symbol from left or right. In these problems, we are trying to find out a pattern. The pattern is, in this question, for example, the second symbol from the right end is fixed. Second symbol from the right end is A. So that's why we are applying this logic in this sort of question. Otherwise, we wouldn't have applied it. You can try with the previous problems also. If it works out, kindly let us all know, then we can think of it as a solution also. Okay. As I told you, kindly send me your solutions also. Whatever you are getting with only one final state, I will go through it and let you know. Okay. So let's see the diagram, what exactly the diagram looks like. For example, we can start with Q0, then Q1. Don't forget we are having two final states according to this logic, Q2 and Q3. Okay, so just trying to fill up the table. Initially, we are starting with Q0. Q0 on input A goes to Q1. Q0 on input B remains in Q0 only. Similarly, Q1 on input A goes to Q3. Q1 on input B goes to Q2. Start filling up for Q2. Q2 on input A goes to Q1. Q2 on input B goes to Q0. Make sure you put up the directions correctly. Similarly, Q3 on input A remains in Q3. Q3 on input B goes to Q2. Okay, this is the diagram which I have got. Now, I'm giving you an example. Simulate it based on this particular logic. So, what is the question demanding from us? The second symbol from the right end should be A. So, take two values, one which is getting accepted and the other value which should not get accepted. Okay. So take such an example, A, B, B, A, and second one, B, A, B, B, A. Okay. Solve these two. Take 5 minutes of time maximum and let me know which is getting accepted and which is getting rejected according to this logic. The first one should get accepted, second one should get rejected. So use your logic, use your simulation and solve this particular problem and let me know whichever is correct. Then we can decide whether we can use this logic or the logic we have been using so far. Okay. Kindly do it and let me know when you're done. First of all, draw the diagram, complete your answers in the notebook, and then solve this particular simulation. Mihir, it ultimately depends upon your comfort level. If you are comfortable drawing the diagram first, as I had already explained earlier also, if you are comfortable drawing the diagram first, you can start with the diagram and then the table. Or if you're comfortable with the table first, you can do it like that. In this case, in our previous two lectures, we have been constructing the diagram first and then the table. But this particular set of problem is slightly different. You can apply your previous logic to this also. There's no harm in that. The only thing is the solution should be correct. If you are getting the simulation correct, I have no issues with it. At the end, I will simply check whether the solution is correct or not. If it is correct, the logic is correct, I will give you full marks. I'm not saying you that you I'm not telling that you have to apply this particular method only. Whichever method you are comfortable with, it should be having four states. Whether it is having one final state or two final state, it doesn't matter. only thing is your logic should be correct and efficient. That's it. Yeah, so the first one is getting accepted. It should get accepted, right? Second one should get rejected according to the logic. So now you can see that this particular logic will hold good for each and every sort of problem, whether it is accepted or whether it is rejected. So this is my logic. I had this shortcut. I had done some research while appearing for the KTE exams, and I found out this logic from various sources. So you can apply this logic for such questions whenever the input from the right end is fixed. You can't apply the same logic for the questions involving the inputs where the left end is fixed. You can apply these logic only for the questions where the symbols from the right end is fixed. You can see that over here the number of states also differ. In the previous case, we had only n plus 2, if I'm not wrong, number of states. But in this case, the formula slightly differs. It is 2 raised to n and not n plus 2. Yeah, this is applicable only for the right one. You can try for the left one. Whenever I tried, I didn't get the answer. So you can try it and then let me know also whether you're getting the solution or not. Okay. So are you comfortable with this logic? Can I give you one more question based on this so that things get more clear? Okay, thank you so much. So take down the next question. Next question I'm dictating, it's a similar question. If third symbol from the right end is B, if third symbol from the right end is B, it goes similarly to this only. The only thing is this time you are fixing the third symbol from the right, and that is B, not A. Okay. So now you will be in a better position to solve such a problem. Third symbol from the right end is fixed, which is B. Start solving, apply the formula, tell me the number of states, tell me the number of final states, and then you can start. Yes, 8 states, 2 raised to 3 is 8. Okay. Also tell me the number of final states, 4 final states, correct. So which are the states which should be marked as final? The bottom 4 states should be marked as final in the table. Okay, according to this logic. So you need to solve it in the same fashion. Do it crisscross, Q0, Q1. Now make sure you are entering the odd values in the B table and not A table. That is the main condition. Okay. You should start entering the odd values of states in the B column and not in the A column. That is the main logic. That is the main difference. That is, Q1 should appear in B column and not in A column. In the previous case, we had Q1 in the A column. But in this case, the odd values should start from the Bth column. Okay. And now we are having states from Q0 to Q7, if I'm not wrong. The question is same only. You have to take. You have to fix the third symbol as B from the right end. Instead of A, it is now B. Okay, and it is third symbol from the right. I'll start it, but first of all, you all try, and then I will start. Okay, done. So let's verify now. I'll construct the table first and then we'll see whether it's correct or not. Because the table is important, you can draw the diagram later on. Okay, have to start with the A column and then the B column. Initial state is Q0, initial of first state, which whatever you want to call. Then Q4, Q5, Q6, and last state is Q7. Okay, so as I told you, you have to start filling up the odd states from Q from B, right? So it will be Q1, Q3, Q5, Q7, and then we have to repeat it. So it will be again Q1, Q3, Q5, and Q7. This is in fact simpler because you will start with Q0 from here and then the crisscross pattern. Okay. So Q0, Q1, next up will be Q2, then Q3, then Q4, and then Q6. Once you get the states finished, again start from Q0. Q0, Q2, Q4, and Q6. So I guess this is a shortcut that will work mostly whenever you have a very less amount of time to solve such problems. It comes really handy in such cases, and even in fact for your gate preparations. Okay, because you will get hardly 2 or 3 minutes to solve a problem based something on this. Okay, so similarly you have to solve this particular problem. So is the table correct? Are you getting the same table? The diagram will be lengthy. Obviously, we are having 8 states, so the diagram will be slightly a bigger one. So you have to draw it carefully, because a single mistake will lead to you losing some marks based on it. Because at the end, we check the diagram and the simulation, the table also at some point of time. If you have made a single mistake in the table or in the diagram, you will not get the full marks which you expect, right? So that's it. This is a shortcut which I had, which I actually had planned to tell you all. I wasn't able to cover this in the previous lecture, so I thought I should do it now. Okay, done with this. Okay. After today's lecture, I will be uploading 2 questions on Google Classroom. That will be your first assignment. Basically, don't take it as an assignment, take it as a practice. You will be able to solve problems. I will try to cover problems which have not been done in the lecture so far. So basically, that would be a practice sort of scenario where you would be able to solve different sort of problems. Okay, so let's take the next set of problems. This will be slightly different. You have not done problems of this type in the past. Question number 3 for the day. You have to design a finite state machine for something like this. That is 0, okay? 0 mod 2. Okay. This is a problem given to you, and you need to construct a finite state machine for this. The diagram is very simple. You will come to know a very easy technique is there to solve this sort of problem. But first of all, understand what this problem is asking you to solve. Can anyone tell me what is it exactly? What is W? What is this mod 2? What is 0? Can anyone tell me what is this? The very first lecture, if you remember the very first lecture, I had told you, what is that mod sign? What is this determinant sign used for? Over here, what is this determinant W, or you can say mod W, is used for? Any idea?
The string length.
String length, correct. The string length. So basically, the string length or the length of the string, when divided by 2, should give me a mod of 0. You're getting it? What I'm trying to say. Basically, this machine is used to accept the strings which are having a length of 2. Why 2? Because anything when divided by 2, if it gives 0 as the input, either 2, sorry, let me repeat it and rephrase it once again. Basically, this is going to accept all the strings which are even number values or even length. Why even length? Because the remainder is zero, correct? So when I divide the string length by two, if the remainder comes out to be zero, it simply means the length of the string is even. If the length is odd, you will end up having a remainder of one, right? So you have to accept all the strings which are having a length of even numbers, okay? So it cannot be a length 5, it can be length 6, but it can't be length 13, okay? So we have to accept a string which is having even length. So we need to design a machine for that. How can you do it? It's very simple. First, tell me what are the number of states, how many states you would require to solve such a problem. Whenever the length of the string is 2 or multiple of 2 or even 0, we can accept it. So basically, it's very simple. 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, whatever be the length of the string, the machine should accept it. Anything apart from this, the machine should reject it. So what is the minimum number of states you would require? I'm getting some answers. I haven't got any correct answer so far. So keep trying. Minimum 3. Okay. Let's see. 5. Okay. Any more guesses? 4. No, 4 is not correct. 3 is not correct. 5 is not correct. Apart from these. Okay. Don't go beyond 4, beyond 3. The answer is 2. Yeah. It's 2. Let me show you how. It's very simple. See, we are starting with the Q0 state. Okay. Q0 will be a final state also, yes or no, because the string length can be 0 also. Right? One state for even and the other state for odd. Correct. So if I start from Q0, if I have a 0 length string, I will accept it and remain in Q0. But if I have a string of length 3, or 3 is not acceptable, okay? So let's take a length of 4. What we should do is, we should construct one more state, Q1, over here. First, length of 1, length of 2, length of 3, length of 4, and so on. So you can see what is happening exactly. If I get a length of 1 over here, I will not end up into a final state. But if I get a length of 2, I can move into a final state. So just suppose you're having a string of length 5. What will happen? Let me take a different color pen. If the string length is 5, the first transition will be from Q0 to Q1, then from Q1 to Q0. So now we are left with 3, right? Because we have read 2 lengths. Same way, again go from this to this, this to this. So now we are left with 1. What happens next? From Q0, I make the final transition to Q1. And I end up having no inputs to read further, right? So the string length has exhausted over here. So I have exhausted all these strings and I end up in the state Q1. Is Q1 a final state? No. Hence, the particular string will not be accepted. You got my point? Whenever the string is having a length of 2 or multiple of 2 or even 0, that particular string will get accepted. That's why I tried using a transition sort of thing so that it goes into your mind better, right? So just modify the question. These sort of questions are basically asked for multiple choice type questions. Okay, Akriti, let me explain once again. Are you able to see the diagram which I have drawn just now? Okay, basically what I did is, I took an example of a string of length 5. So what happened is the machine starts from Q0. It made the first transition from Q0 to Q1. This is the first transition. The second transition will be from Q1 to Q0. So now what I have done is I have read 2 inputs out of these. So we are left with 3 length, correct? So we have basically read 2 inputs, 3 inputs are left. What we'll do is we'll read the third input. It can be 0 or 1, whatever. We don't bother about the inputs, we just bother about the length of the string. Okay, so third input will be read over here, fourth will be read over here, and the same fashion we would be left with a single input over here. So at the end, I will read the final input, that is fifth character, and I end up in Q1. So as a result, I will end up reading all the inputs, and I'm left with, and I'm basically present in a non-final state. So basically, if I'm present in a non-final state and all my inputs are exhausted, I cannot say that the input is accepted. Hence, a string of length 5 will not be accepted using this logic. On the other hand, if I had one more input left, for example, I had 6 characters, I would have made the final transition from Q1 to Q0, and I would have accepted that as the final string, as the length is even. Or you can say the length is divisible by 2. Hence, such a problem comes basically for multiple choice questions, where you would be given a question something like this, for example, something like this, and you would be asked how many states are required to draw such a problem. If you are preparing for GATE or any other competitive exams, you have to solve such problems very quickly, because you hardly get any time to solve such problems. Okay, understood? I hope the concept is clear. Okay. Okay. For example, if I want to make a slight change to the question, if I wish to replace this 0 mod 2 by 1 mod 2, what should you do? It's very simple. Think of it. The remainder should be 1 in this case and not 2. Correct. So it should accept odd numbers. So what change should I make to the diagram? Correct. Q1 will be my final state in such a case. Q0 will read the first input and Q1 will be my final state. Clear? Simple enough? In this question, the answer should be same for any set of alphabets. Yes, the alphabets don't bother in this particular case. We are just bothered with the length of the string. So I can take 0, 1. So what you can see in the diagram, I have written 0, 1. So whatever be the inputs, it doesn't matter. We just bother with the length of the particular string. Okay. So take down one more question based on this only. It is something like this. This is a congruency sign, okay? This is not equal to, this is congruency sign. Okay. 2 mod 3. Now the question is read something like this. If the length of the string is divided by 3, it should give a mod of 2. So you should end up having a remainder 2. Okay. So if we end up having a remainder 2, what are the various possible string lengths that could be accepted? Can you tell me? It will start with 2, obviously. Now you can't have 0. You can't have 0 as your initial final state. Why? Because the remainder is not 0 mentioned over here. The remainder is starting from 2. So you can't have Q0 as your final state. So the minimum string length that this sort of machine would accept is 2. And what next? After 2, what should it accept? Any number which when divided by 3 gives a mod 2. Yes, correct. That is 5. So basically what you need to do is, once you get the minimum value, keep on adding 3 into it. Keep on adding 3 to it. So it becomes 2, 5, 8, 11 and so on. Okay, cool. It is n plus 3, correct. So now, draw the diagram for this. How many states you would require to solve this? If you anyhow get this particular thing, na, see how many strings can be accepted, the minimum value, then you will easily be able to draw the diagram. Why? Because see, we know that this particular machine will accept all strings of length 2. So anyhow, this will be accepted. See the diagram properly. So anyhow, this particular combination will be accepted. Yes or no? So I know that Q2 will be my final state. Yes. So we require 3 states. And what about the next inputs? For example, the next input is 5. What I can do is, first input is read over here. Second input is read over here. Third input could be read like this, because we are again going back to the initial state. Fourth one over here and fifth one over here. And this continues in a loop. Are the things clear? Let me explain it once again. I'm taking an example of a string with 5 characters. Okay. If I have a string with 5 characters, what I will do is, first will be read over here, second over here. And now where should I go to? Because I need 3 more characters to be read. So I make a transition back to the Q0 state. This will be my third character. Again, repeat the same process. This will be my fourth character. And last, finally, this will be my fifth character. And I will end up reading all the characters. And I will also make a transition into the final state. Okay, I will draw the table for this. No issues. The diagram is clear, right? Simply follow the diagram and you would be able to construct the table. I'm having three states, Q0, Q1, and Q2. So Q0 on input 0 and 1, whatever be it, it goes to Q1. Simple. Similarly, Q1 on input 0 or 1, whatever be it, it goes to Q2. It's very simple. In fact, a table is not even required for it. In Q2, whatever be the inputs, let me write it over here, it will go to Q0. It's a linear sort of diagram. We are not bothered about the inputs. We are simply bothered about the length of the particular inputs. Clear? So same way you can draw a table for the previous question also. This is how you solve such problems where you try to find out the length of the inputs. Clear? Yeah, Q2 is my final state. Sorry, I forgot to mention over here. Q2 is marked as star and it is the final state. Because we can read any characters which when divided by 3 gives a mod of 2. Clear? Correct, because of remainder 2. Okay, so do you want me to give more such problems? Yes. I hope you all are enjoying this subject. Okay. So this is going to be a slightly trickier problem because it is having two parts. First of all, let's see the first part, it's simpler one, and then we can move ahead with the second part. The first one is similar to this. Write down this question. This question number fourth, I guess, for the day. I'm simply writing the question. You can design a finite state machine. Okay. Strings starting with 0 and length is divisible by 3. Think of it first. The string should start with 0. And the length of the string should be divisible by 3. So this is nothing but an application of the problems we have done so far today. The strings are starting with 0. So the first character should be a 0. It cannot be a 1. I'm giving you a hint. The first character cannot be 1. Okay. And the length should be divisible by 3. So basically you need to do some changes to your 0 mod 3 sort of problems. You have to add this restriction. That is, the string should start with 0. And the length of it should be divisible by 3. Correct. Manav has written, Ayush has written, it is basically mod 3, 0 mod 3, but there is slight change. What is the change? See clearly what could be the change. Initial condition, okay. Initial condition, okay. We are having two inputs, obviously, but yeah, we need to add a dead state. Correct, Yashi. Because what exactly happens is the strings should start with 0. It should not start with a 1. Okay. It should start with 0 and the length should be divisible by 3. Okay. So the strings could be something like this: 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, whatever. Okay. After this, we need to keep on adding 3 to it. Yes. So the strings could be multiples of 5, multiples of 3, we can say something like this, whatever be it. So basically we need to add one condition to the initial state and it will be similar to your 0 mod 3 sort of problem. Can you do it? Kindly solve it. Kindly draw the diagram first and let me know whether you are done with it. Okay, solve it first. I'll draw it, but first you people try and then let me know. Yeah, you can do it with 4 states. Carefully draw it because I guess you people might make a small mistake over here. I'm doubtful. And if you're able to do it correctly, then it's really commendable. See over here, we are going to start with Q0. States are 4, no issues with that. As we know that the first symbol should be a 0. Because it should start with 0, right? So q0, q1. If I get the first symbol as 1, it will simply move me into a dead state. Okay. So it is, sorry, states are 5, not 4. My bad. Because we also have that dead state. Okay. There are 5 states, not 4 states. I have simply drawn the initial configuration. Just check once. This is the initial configuration. We take the first input at 0. It should be 3. Okay, so I know that there will be 2 more states over here. Something like this and something like this. Where Q3 will be my final state. Correct? So after reading the first input as 0, I'm not bothered about the second input. It can be a 0 or it can be even a 1. Right? Can we have a trap state over here? Kindly let me know. Can we have a trap state at Q3 or not? No. Okay. No, we can't have a trap state because we need to do some more checking whether this particular number, whether the length of the number is divisible by 3 or not. So the very first transition from here is, let's assume that the length of the particular string is 3. So if the length is 3, I can easily accept it because it is starting from 0. Suppose the string is something like this, 0, 1, 0. So I will read the first 0, move to Q1. Okay. Then the second input is 1. So I will accept it, move to Q2. Next input, final input is 0. I will accept it and move to Q3. Simple situation. Yeah. Correct. This is the main thing I was trying to say. The transition will be from Q3 to Q1 and not to Q0. Why? Because we want the length to be divisible by 3. So if we make a transition from Q3 to Q0, we already are making one increment to the length over here. Yes or no? Because it is 1, 2, 3. It will be 4th increment over here, then 5th over here, then 6th, and then 7th. So what happens exactly? The length of the string becomes 7. We don't want that. What we want the length to be divisible by 3. So if we want to make it divisible by 3, then we need to make it a multiple of 3 also. So that's why we make a transition from Q3 to Q1. Now what happens? It is 1, it is 2, it is 3, it is 4, 5, and 6. So hence the numbers 3, 6, 9, 12, ... will be easily accepted by this machine provided it is starting from 0. Okay, so what we are doing is we are fixing the first symbol as 0, and after that it can be either 2 digits or 5 digits, or we can say 8 digits, and so on. Clear? I hope this is clear now. Just complete the diagram. I have written a few things on top of it that is not needed. You simply put on the the inputs, okay, on top of it and complete the diagram. I hope this was clear. This is a slightly trickier sort of problem. I had already mentioned while starting the lecture, these problems are slightly tricky, but once you get the logic, you will understand it clearly. Okay, I will explain it once again. Let's see what happens. The question is something like this. The string should start with 0 and the length of the total string should be divisible by 3. Okay, so if we are talking about the total length of the string, we have to make a transition from Q3 to Q1. Okay, yeah, both 0, 1. Q3 to Q1, we can make a transition with both the inputs. Why? Because we are only bothered with the first input. The first input should be a 0. After that, whatever may be the input, we don't care. We simply want the length to be divisible by 3. Okay, so the first input is red over here. It is the first input. This is second input. This is third input. And if we make a transition from Q3 to Q0, that would be fourth input, then fifth, sixth, and seventh. That we don't want. So I'm repeating it once again. Instead of making a transition from Q3 to Q0, something similar to this. Over here, we made a transition from Q2 to Q0 because the question, particular question was like that only. But in this case, what we are doing is, the question is having a particular condition that the length should be divisible by 3. Whenever I'm saying length, I'm discussing about the total length. Okay, so that's why I made a transition from Q3 to Q1. Okay, so now it will be the fourth value over here, then fifth, and then 6. Count the total number of arrows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we are having 6 arrows, which simply means 6 is the length. So I hope this is clear now. You can draw the table with the same logic. Just make sure that QD is added in the table. We are having 5 states instead of 4 states. Clear? Any more explanation needed on this particular question? Kindly let me know if required. What about others? Kindly let me know, kindly acknowledge if you got this or not. Okay, thank you so much. So take down a problem. You can either do it in homework because it's slightly lengthy. Based upon the same theory, based upon the same logic. Okay, I'm writing the question over here. You have to follow the same logic, but it's a little lengthier than this particular diagram. Okay, question number 5 for the day. Strings starting with 0, 1, 0 and length is equal to 3 mod 5. Okay. So now over here, what is happening? We have combined all the logics from question number 2, 3, 4. And combining it into a single question. Over here, what you need to do is you need to check whether it is starting with this particular pattern. So we are following question number 4's logic. Over here, we need to check whether the length is equal to 3 mod 5. So we are following question number 2nd and question number 3rd's logic. So it's a combined question. Okay. Try to solve it and tell me the number of states you would require. Try to solve it. If it is comfortable for you, try to do it now only because we are still having 30 minutes of time. You can try it. I just think of it once again, whether it will be 8 or anything else. Yeah, we also need the dead state in this case also because the string has to start with 0, 1, 0. So we require one more state. Correct. The number of states would be 9. Number of states would be 9. Think of it properly. Start solving it. The first substring or the first pattern that we want is 0, 1, 0. And after that, try to follow the question. The length is 8 plus 1 dead state. So it is simple. You can call it as n plus 1, where n is the length. Okay. Length you can simply find out using this formula. This plus this. 3 plus 5 is 8. 8 would be the length. Okay. And plus 1 is nothing but your dead state. So in total, you can apply the formula over here and try to find out the total number of states. It will be 8 states plus 1 dead state. That is total 9 states. Yes, Vinay, I will upload yesterday's lecture and today's lecture on Google Classroom. I will put up the link. You can go through it. I guess today's lecture is highly logical, so you need to practice a lot. Because each and every question is having a different logic. That is what happens at the end of the semester. When all the chapters are included, you get confused. So you need to keep on practicing a lot. That is the main, what you can say, problem in this particular subject. Otherwise, everything is same. Yeah, even lecture 6 is remaining. I remember I will upload 6, 7 and today's 8th lecture. Today I will upload 2 lectures if possible. And this one, either today if possible or tomorrow. Okay. So let me put up the attendance link. You keep on practicing this problem, try to solve it, and then let me know if it's complete or not. you're having any doubts, you can ask me. We are still having 10 minutes of time with us. I have a few more questions, but that will be really overburdening for today, because so much questions in one day would be really difficult. Try to practice these 5 questions. I will also put up some questions for practice in your Google Classroom. Go through it. It will be your assignment number 1. Okay. Yeah, initial check ke baad you need to consider the condition. Condition kya diya hai? It should be 3 mod 5. Okay. So 3 mod 5 means what? 3 mod 5 kya hoga? 3 mod 5 means it can even accept strings of length 3. Yes or no? So the acceptable lengths are nothing but 3. Next kya hoga? Any number which when divided by 5 gives you a remainder 3. What will be the next value? Correct. Yeah, 8. So construct a machine which will accept the states, third state and 8. I'm saying 8th state, it doesn't mean that you have to construct 2 final states. I simply mean that whenever you are making the third transition and 8th transition, that should move the machine into a final state. You're getting what I'm trying to say? Whenever you're making the third transition and the 8th transition, the machine should enter into a final state. If that is clear. We also saw it in the previous cases also. You want me to construct the diagram or you can do it on your own? And you let me know. Anyways, in the next lecture, I will show it to you. N mod M is N plus M. Yeah, that is the number of, number of states plus 1 dead state. Total 9 states. Okay, so that is what I mean. Whenever you are making the third transition, it simply means the length is 3. 1 second, I was clear. Can you please repeat? Yes, Jyoti, could you please repeat? I couldn't hear you properly.
Is it valid input or not?
Correct. So valid input matlab 0 1 0 hoga, to usko accept karega. Theek hai? Agar 0 1 1 hua, to accept nahi hoga. वो चेक करने के बाद कैसे करना? वो चेक करने के बाद देखो मैं बता वो चेक आपने किया मतलब आपने 3 लेंथ तक चेक कर लिया राइट तो उसके बाद क्या है उसके बाद और 5 नंबर्स ऐड करेंगे तो 8 मिलेगा हमें राइट सो यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट द 5th ट्रांजिशन आफ्टर द 3rd स्टेट लेट मी ड्रॉ द डायग्राम इट विल लेट मी ड्रॉ द स्ट्रक्चर इट विल मेक थिंग्स क्लियर. For example, this is Q0, this is Q1, this is Q2, and this is Q3. Okay, pehla transition yaha pe, second yaha pe, third yaha pe, right? So according to my condition, according to my question, this is my final state, Q3. Because over here, if the condition is matched, that is, if it is 0, 1, 0, I will move into final state. Iske alawa kuch hua. Apart from this, if any input we are getting, we will simply move to the dead state. Simple. So over here, if I get a 1, over here, if I get a 0, over here, if I get one more 1, I will end up into the dead state. Is it clear till now? Don't worry, I will draw a fair diagram in the next lecture. I'm just drawing it for the understanding purpose. Clear? So after this, what happens? Maine kya bola tha? String of length 3 plus 8, 3 plus 5, 8. What will be the next one? I guess 13. You need to keep on adding 5, right? So it will accept string of length 3, then 8, and then 13. So already aapne 3 read kar liya hai. What you should do? You should read 5 more so that you end up into state Q3. How you can do so? It's really very simple. Or pass transitions badhna aapko. This is one transition. This is second. It could be Q5. This is third. Okay. What you can do is make the fourth transition Q7. And this final transition should end up again into Q3 if it is clear. Aapne 3 inputs yahan pe read kiye, you read these inputs, aapka length 3 ho gaya. Initial check aapne yahan pe kar liya. Next up, over here you are reading the 5 characters more. It can be 0, 1, any value it can have, okay? Because we are not bothered about the inputs after that, we are simply bothered about the length. So from Q7 state, I am jumping to Q3 state, which is my final state. Is it clear? Is the diagram clear now? then according to the logic, the sum we solved before of 2 mod 3, the states 5 aane chahiye the. Kindly check the question once again, 2 mod 3 wala. Limit. चेक करो ध्यान से, 2 mod 3, 2 पे 3 ऐड करेंगे तो 5 होता है ना, वही किया है ना, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Is it clear now? The same thing we have done in all the questions, the same logic we have applied. The length is important. Clear? Sorry for this rough diagram. In the next lecture I will draw it clearly. It was just for understanding purpose. If I'm clear with this diagram, kindly let me know. If you are clear with this, total, it will accept strings of length 3 and then we keep on adding 5 to it. Pehle 3 hoga, fir 8 hoga, and then it will be 13. Right? And so on. Clear? So done with the lecture for the day. Let's meet on Saturday, I guess. Yeah, next lecture. The timetable has changed, so now it's on Saturday. Follow the new timetable, only Saturdays and Fridays lectures have shuffled. Rest all remains same. Saturday, same time from 10 to 11.